Good morning. Good morning. Nice to be here, having the sun come up, a light dusting of snow on the ground, chill to the air, and hope for a new day. I'd like to thank the Massillon Museum for this opportunity. And if you've been following the virtual yoga, please consider a donation to the Massillon Museum. So we'll get grounded. Still continuing our January month of hope. Finding our breath, setting our intention with a soft gaze or maybe our eyes closed. Hope lives here. I am hope. Finding your breath, finding your stillness. This is your mat and your practice. Hope lives here. Let's set our hands back by our hips, leaning back into them, elongating the spine, opening up our heart. When our heart opens, peace enters, hope. Taking our gaze up towards the sky. A couple cleansing breaths. Deep inhale, really filling up that chest. And exhale, maybe even letting out a little sigh. One more inhale. And exhale. Taking our right arm behind us, placing our left hand on our knee, taking our gaze over our right shoulder. Breathing into this nice twist. Two more breaths. And when you've completed those breaths, we'll meet on the other side, taking the left hand, elongating the spine, supporting ourselves with that left hand, right hand over left knee. Twisting to the left side. Good morning, sun. Coming to center, putting our hands behind our hips, opening up our heart, and let's switch our legs. Opening up that heart. Pushing into those palms, taking that gaze up towards the sky. One more inhalation and exhalation. Planting the right arm out, taking our left ear to the left shoulder, opening up, elongating. We'll breathe into this three times. then we'll take that arm out to the left, taking the right ear to right shoulder. Again, breathing into this, opening up that left side. One more breath. Bending into that left side, taking the right arm overhead. Nice side stretch. Breathe. Coming up, placing that right arm on the mat, bringing the left arm up overhead. Stretching into that right side with some welcoming breath. And back to neutral. Let's do some seated cat and cow. With the inhalation, opening up that heart, letting that peace enter, and with an exhalation, folding down, taking your gaze to your ankles, rounding that back slowly, slowly. Inhaling, taking that gaze up, elongating, opening up that heart, and move through this a few times on your own. And when you've completed the next rotation, we'll find ourselves together in an upright posture. Nice. Let's roll our shoulders back, bringing them up, rolling them down, adding some movement to the arms. And let's go forward. A couple more rotations. Forward. Bring that to a close. And let's take our shoulders and roll them up and back. And I'm going to change my position here on the mat so you can see. Pushing my shoulder blades together so they're up and back, opening up my heart. We're going to hold them here for a little bit and really, really feel the opening of our heart. Heart opens, peace enters. And let's release. Okay, taking one leg out, let's bring our right leg into our inner thigh. And if you want to watch this first, I'll show you what we're going to do. We're going to walk our fingertips out, just slowly walk them out, and then we'll walk them back in. And I'm just demonstrating. Then over to this side, out by our knee, we're going to walk our fingers out. And then we're going to walk them in. And then we're going to walk them out again. And open up the left, bringing our hand down to our ear, and we'll do some folds in, bringing that left elbow to the right knee. So that's our movement, and then we'll repeat it with the left leg tucked in and the right leg extended out. So let's sit up straight, engaging that left leg, right leg bent. Let's walk our fingers out like as if we're a cat. Folding gently, holding that, but do not hold your breath. Breathe into it. Breathing. Feeling that nice stretch on your left hamstring. We'll move up. Take a cleansing breath up here and just notice. Take a twist over that right knee. Let's walk those hands out again like a cat. Walk it out, stretch into that, stretch into it. You might notice your left hip comes off the mat. That's okay. And then moving up a little bit, just so your left hip lands back on that mat, taking that right arm out over that knee, extend the left hand, breathing into it, breathing into it, bringing that left hand behind the head or near the ear, and we're folding that left elbow to the right knee. And we'll do this a couple times with our breath, exhaling as we come into our knee, inhaling as we go back. And we'll have one more. And we'll meet in neutral. Meeting in neutral, extending that right leg out, taking the left leg in. We'll do the same thing. So, sitting up, noticing, taking and walking those hands out. Stretching, breathing, coming back up. Inhalation, exhalation, and then we'll proceed over that left knee. Folding over the left knee. Noticing that the right hip and sits bone off the mat. Coming back up slowly until that right sits bone is sitting on the mat, extending that right arm to the right, left arm on the mat. Taking that hand behind the head, and we'll take that elbow, the right elbow, to the left knee. And open. Exhale. Inhale as you open. We'll do this two more times. Nice. Coming back up. Extending that left leg out. Let's just sit here. Maybe shake out those legs and just bask in the glory of that movement. Notice your shoulders, how different they feel. Notice your breath. And taking those arms up overhead, let's walk those fingers out towards our feet in a forward fold. Folding into it. Noticing with it, each inhalation, moving a little bit closer. And we'll come up. And this time when we come down, we'll do another forward fold. Let's cross our hands at our shins or our ankles and see if we can get our head to rest on the X that we're making. So beginning to forward fold, you can have a slight bend in your knees. No, don't force it. If there's pinching or binding, back out of it. But just slowly begin to move into a forward fold. Resting your head on the X marks the spot. And coming up, noticing which arm is on top. As we come up, cross your arms in the other direction. And we'll move into that forward fold again. Breathing into the X marking the spot. Slowly rolling out of that. Let's put our hands behind our hips, feet in front of us, and let's push up into a reverse table. Reverse table. And come down with our feet about mat distance apart. Let's fold, dial our knees from side to side. Just dial those knees to the right and to the left, and to the right, and to the left. And the next time we're on that right side, taking those legs in 90 degree angles. So my front leg is a 90 degree angle and my back leg is at a 90 degree angle. Let's walk our catwalk, our hands out to the right. You can also make a pocket for your head, opening up that hip, breathing into it, breathing into it. So this might be your comfortable spot today. Your comfortable spot might be here today. Wherever you find the road to just slight resistance. No pinching or binding. Make sure you're breathing. We'll come up out of that, bringing the legs in front of you, switching them to the opposite side, 90 degree angle on the front leg and the back leg, and we'll begin to walk our hands over to this side. Folding over that left knee. Slowly coming up, bringing the legs, and we'll meet in table. We'll do some cat and cow. Inhaling, really arching that back. With the exhalation, and as you're doing this exhalation and this cow, see if you can move the palms of your hands and your knees together and see how that feels in your core. And then as we exhale into cat, push those palms and those fingertips away from your knees and your knees away from your palms. And get a little bit more resistance in this movement. And we'll bring this to a halt. I'm going to start with my table here. I'm going to take my right leg out and pushing up into a downward dog. So you can do it this way, or if you'd like, you could start and push up into a downward dog and take that foot out to the right. So the right foot is out to the right. And just notice that. Notice. Bringing that foot back and then taking the left foot out. So taking that left foot out. Again, you can be down on your knee if you'd like, or you can be up in a downward dog, bringing that leg back, pressing in to that dog, and back down to table. Let's come up, on our knees. If you're on a harder surface, you might want to put a blanket or a towel under your knees. Taking that right leg out. Let's do a nice side bend. Taking that right arm down, right side of the leg. Make sure you're breathing. We'll drop that left arm, taking the right arm up overhead. This may be where you are today. If you'd like to lift up that right leg, feel free to do so. Don't forget to breathe. Open up that heart, let the peace enter. Coming up, and we'll close there. Arms out in an airplane, taking that left leg out, dropping the left arm to the left leg. Nice bend. Remember to open your heart, let peace enter, spread peace, spread hope. Ah, the joy will come. Dropping the right arm, taking the left arm up. Nice side stretch. Like a little bit of more muscle engagement, take that left leg off the mat. So we're balancing, we're strengthening. Bring that movement to a close. Let's tuck our toes under. So I was like this. Let's tuck our toes under and sit back on those toes, opening them up. And for some of you, this might not be the most comfortable, but we won't stay here long. Just kind of putting a little bit of pressure in those toes. Open them up, tuck them under. We'll go back to table. Let's tuck those toes, pushing up into our downward dog. Finding a little bit of movement. Taking your left hand towards your right shin or knee or ankle. A little bit of strength. Back to downward dog. And then the right arm to the left. Again, you can do calf, ankle, or knee. One arm dog. Bring that to close. Let's take our knees down and go into child's pose with three cleansing breaths. Breathe. Breathe. We'll push back up into downward dog. kicking the right leg up. Bringing it down, taking the left leg up. Bringing it down. And let's walk those hands and feet together. And you can move up to the front of your mat. I'm going to change my orientation just so you can see us. We'll do some balancing here. If you're on your mat, you can always move to a more solid footing. Move off your mat. If you're on carpeting, you might want to have a chair nearby. Sometimes carpeting can have you wobble like a weeble. So let's shake out our legs. Let's rotate our shoulders a little bit, taking our arms wide. Circling. And let's do the opposite. One more circle and we'll come to neutral. And shake it out. Let's do a scan of our body and just notice. Are we standing a little bit taller? Do our shoulders feel open? Does our heart feel open? Take our gaze to the left and the right. And we'll lift and lower our right leg. So let's lift and lower, and lift and lower. And the next time you have it lifted, let's keep it up. Keep it up there. And taking that right knee with the right hand, let's open that leg, taking the arm to the left. So, and again, you can always hold on to something if you'd like. So, taking, you play around with it a little bit today, I guess my balance today, find a focal point, and let's hold that. So, it might take you a little practice this morning. It's practice, it's a journey, no perfection. Bring that down, shake it out, and then let's do the same with lowering and raising that left knee. Again, you could use something to help you maintain bringing that left leg up, holding the left knee with the left arm, and opening up that right arm. Finding a focal point. Maybe using something to help you with your balance. And we'll bring that to a close. Whew. Shake that out. We'll lift and lower that right leg again. And this time, let's see if we can grab that right knee with the left arm. Again, we might want to hold on to something. Get our balance. Taking that arm overhead. finding a focal point, feeling that left leg strengthen. Very nice. Bring it down. Shake it out. Lifting and lowering the left leg again. When you're ready, taking that left knee in the right hand. Finding your balance, finding a focal point, and opening up that left arm. Very nice. Okay. Oh, taking our arms up overhead. We'll do a couple forward folds to get some energy going. Forward fold. Halfway up. Forward fold. Bending those knees. Coming up. Hands to prayer and heart center. We'll do this a couple more times, taking the arms up overhead, forward fold, halfway up, forward fold, bending, coming up, hands to prayer and heart center. We'll sit down, roll back, find ourselves. In a position, bringing our knees up about mat distance apart, arms out to a T. Let's dial those knees right and left and right and left. You know, during the course of the week, it's so important to just move. We can't get out as much as we'd like. The weather's a little bit chillier. Even if you just move a little bit like this every day, you'll be surprised in a week's time or a month's time how much more energy you have. Taking that right leg in and up, left leg bent. Let's massage that right leg. Thigh, hugging it into our chest, taking it up, rolling that ankle, rolling it the other way, roll that ankle, bringing that right leg down. Taking the left leg up. Let's massage that left leg. Thigh. Hug it in. Take it up. And bring it down. Let's go into our invisible seat. So the knees are at a 90 degree angle, legs are at a 90 degree angle. And let's hold this. Let's just hold it. We can have our arms out to a T or they could be down by our side. And let's hug those knees into our chest and fold up into a little itsy bitsy ball, as small as you can possibly get. And then let's extend a little bit, holding those knees at that 90 degree angle. And dial them a little bit to the right. Back to center. And a little bit to the left. And then back to center. And then let's roll up into a tiny little ball again. Tiny, tiny little ball. And slowly unravel. Extending our legs straight. We'll get ready for Shavasana. Yogic sleep. Maybe clenching your fists and flexing your feet and releasing. And we'll do that one more time, clenching our feet and our legs. And our hands and our palms, and maybe even our face this time, and release. Invite you to stay here, or if you need to get on with your day, begin moving your fingers and your toes, finding a little bit of movement. Maybe taking your arms up over your head as if waking up for the first time in the morning, rolling to one side and slowly coming up to a seated position. Extending our arms wide. Let's hug ourselves. Thank ourselves for spending this time on hopeful intention. Spreading our arms one more time. Crossing them the opposite way. Extending them, bringing your palms together, taking them to heart center. I challenge each and every one of you to spread the word of hope to a family member, a colleague, or maybe a random stranger that is looking to you for a hopeful message. Namaste.